you ask a lot of people that know me, they'll always tell you that growing up I was a Fadolo nigga, man. I mean, I always had a group of people around me, but I really never was a part of a team growing up, like, you know?
Start it.
Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team fucking here. Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here, nigga. Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team here, nigga. Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team fucking here. I done kept it real from the jump. Living at my mama's house, we'd argue every month, nigga. I was trying to get it on my own. Working all night, traffic on the way home. And my uncle calling me like, where you at? I gave you the keys, so you bring it right back, nigga. I just think it's funny how it goes.
In 2008, James came and sat me down, man, and he had a heart-to-heart conversation with me about my music, and it just showed me how real of a person he was. And from that conversation, the relationship only got stronger till then, man. That's my brother. Eggy's a nigga I knew my whole life, you know? We grew up in the same neighborhoods, we just never hung out until around 2009, and it's crazy because God just sends the right people in your life when you need them. He ended up being one of the realest niggas I ever met in my life, and since James was already my man and Eggy was my boy, we just started chilling together, man, three the hard way. To talk about Chris, I'll be here all night. Me and him had a mutual friend, man, and rest his soul, his friend passed away, and that was his best friend at the time, and I just seen the pain he was going through, and I could relate to it, and I just looked at him and said, you know what? I just wanted to try and fill the shoes that his best friend had, and he been here with me since then, man. That's one of the realest niggas in my life, man. I appreciate his friendship to me so much. JB, oh man, that's just another real nigga in my team. Thing about JB is he one of the biggest DJs in Brooklyn, one of the biggest promoters in Brooklyn. He was already himself. He had no reason to join the team, you know what I mean? But it's just real respect real, man, and that's a real statement because we started hanging out. He just had to be part of the circle, man. We keep a real small circle and JB had to be part of it. Ever since one day, JB is family first. JR, I'ma keep this one simple. He's just a real nigga, man. But it's not everybody in the team you need to know about, man. Just know that he's there. JR, holla at me, man.
From different races, you get money, they started hating.
I woke up in a new Bugatti. 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 I woke up in a new Bugatti.
Niggas be hating, I'm rich as a bitch. 100K, I spent that on my wrist. $200, spent that on your bitch. Do me your model, put that on my list.
Yeah. I ain't gonna hold y'all up. I wanna appreciate everybody that came out tonight. I had a good time. Shouts to my brothers in the building, JB, James, Eddie, JR, Ren. Don't forget Chris, I like my nigga, KR. Everybody here, Craig, what up? Cap is in the building, L, what up? I appreciate y'all, man. I ain't gonna hold y'all up. Happy birthday to me.
Okay? Tout le monde à la caillou à Queen.
Rest in peace, my nigga Scrooge. Happy birthday, Sunan.
Shout out to my brothers, Prina Prez, Chris Credible, King Fata. Happy birthday to y'all. Y'all my niggas for life, you heard? Great event, successful event. A lot of fucking ladies in the building.
JR, wanna talk now. JR,
I just gonna say one more thing, man.
What up?
I mean, family first is a real family, man. I'm blessed to be a part of it, man. Shout out to my nigga Prem, Eggy, James, JB. I love y'all niggas. Y'all niggas is my brothers, for real.
Shouts to family first, man. My brothers from day one. Shouts to my nigga Prezi Supreme. My nigga A. A know who he is, man. A.L. Al. Shouts to my nigga Al. Shouts to King Fata. Incredible, everybody, man. My brothers, I love y'all niggas, man. Party, success. What's up, man?
I kind of deserved it. I've been violating everybody all year with the champagne.
Speaking of violation, because we got that on footage. What is your take on how you were violated?
See, the thing is, I know I do it to everybody, so I expected it tonight. I ain't going to lie to you. That's why I ain't go too hard with an outfit, because niggas would have violated me in it anyway. But the reason why they caught me good, I was taking a picture with my homegirl. So my mom wasn't on it. I was waiting on it.
No, you don't have to explain to me.
I was waiting on it because I knew they was going to do it. And I told them, don't do it before 3:30. So every minute after 3:30, I was expecting it. But I was taking a picture with my homegirl. And as I was on my way up, pause.
This nigga talk about niggas OD on him. Fuck out of here. Yo, I watched the video from my birthday party. You know what's so crazy? I'm talking on the camera. You got me talking on the camera. While I'm talking to you, this nigga behind me, like, yo, you about to get this nigga. You about to get this nigga. He started it. And he talking about we OD. That's my motherfucking brother, man. Family first, Prina Prez. Happy birthday again, my nigga.
Everybody, thank you for coming to the party. I'm from Jacmel, Haiti. My mother is from Port-au-Prince, and my father is from Kafu. So he's...
Shout out to JR, shout out to Eggy. No, we don't call him Eggy no more. Call him Scrams now. Shout out to Scrams.
Yo, I don't know where JB got that name from. It's still Eggy.
Started from the bottom, now my whole team fucking here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Nigga, started from the bottom, now we here.